Hello, I'm Denise Galloni. Welcome to today's episode of Empowering You. My guest today is Kathi Hull. Kathi is the Fayette Business Education Partnership Coordinator for the Fayette Chamber of Commerce. She's going to talk to you today about the things that the Fayette Chamber are doing and also some amazing programs that they're doing for children and students in the high schools in Fayette County. It's so inspiring and empowering what they're doing for these students. I can't wait for you to meet her and hear about it. Kathi is the Fayette Business Education Partnership Coordinator. Kathi was hired by the Fayette Chamber of Commerce in January of 2018 to coordinate and support the efforts of the Fayette Business Education Partnership and coordinating workforce efforts between business and education. She works closely with area businesses and schools to provide programming and will help students decide on their career paths through programs such as Spark Fayette and Mechanical Design Competition. Kathi is working hard to build collaborative partnerships between business, education, and workforce, and creating sustaining workforce development activities throughout Fayette County. Kathi was born and raised in Fayette County and currently lives in Connellsville. Before joining the Chamber staff, she worked for the Westmoreland Fayette Workforce Investment Board and the PA CareerLink Fayette County. Welcome, Kathi.
Hi, nice to see you again.
Cecilia, thank you so much for being here.
We do go way back.
A lot of my guests on my show I've known since I became an entrepreneur and through my business dealings, but you, I've known you way before that.
Yeah, way before that. And I watched you grow into what you are today.
And you too, like you've changed a lot too.
Yes.
So now you work for the Chamber of Commerce.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Fayette County Chamber of Commerce.
So what exactly does the Chamber of Commerce do?
So we say in our world, when you've seen one chamber, you've seen one chamber. Because all chambers are different. Some have economic development attached to them. Some have tourism attached to them. We do have partnerships with our tourism community as well as our economic development. But we work a lot with our county. We work a lot with county government. We work really hard to promote the county in the way to make it look and sound more efficient, if that makes any sense. But what a chamber does is we are an advocacy marketing organization for our business community. One of the things that we have taken on, which is what I coordinate, is the Fayette Business Education Partnership, which works with, like you said, and when you read the bio, workforce agencies, education, and businesses. So about 12 years ago, my executive director put out a survey to our businesses and said, what's an issue that you're facing? And a lot of them were facing getting skilled workers.
Sure.
And it hasn't really changed over those years.
It's even worse, I think.
Yes. And then that's how the Business Education Partnership was formed. And then that she's always wanted to have a coordinator, always wanted to do more in-school programming. And finally, an opportunity happened. And that's how I ended up here 5 years ago, coordinating the Fayette Business Education Partnership and doing programming like what we're going to talk about later.
Well, that's really interesting, Kathi, because like you said, a lot of Chamber of Commerce do different things.
Yes.
I'm always impressed with Fayette County, how they do focus on the community and the students and just so many other things, not just local businesses. Of course, that's part of it, but you really get more involved with the community.
Yeah, we pull our businesses into those programs. So we have our what we call the Fayette Living Well Coalition. We're working to work to make a healthy living here in Fayette County. We are involved in the Tourism Alliance. Fayette County is very rich in tourism. I mean, we have Falling Water. We do have, and Seven Springs may claim to be in Somerset, but we have a ski slope in Fayette County. We have Nemacolin. We have the summit, which you can see behind me and this picture over here. I mean, we do have a lot of tourist locations here in Fayette County. So we work with our tourism community. We do a lot of community work here. And we also make sure that we cover our businesses and what their needs are and focus on them. But we include them in the needs of the county because they're most important. If you don't have business, you can't really function in the county.
That's right. And that's so true. I'm glad you mentioned those places because when I think of Fayette County, I think of like Uniontown. But there's just so much more than Uniontown and Fayette County.
Yes, there is so much more than Uniontown. In Connellsville, where I live, we have the Great Allegheny Passage that goes straight through. It's a trail. And you can take that trail from Ohio Pile all the way down to Washington, D.C. And they're expanding that further into Maryland. And that goes right through my hometown. We have Fort Necessity, which is...
Oh my gosh, that's right. I forgot about that.
Yeah, we have so much tourists here in Fayette County and people don't realize it. We have focused efforts in tourism to Baltimore, which you kind of think is weird. But our Go Laurel Highlands, which is our local tourism agency that we're a partner with, they focused our efforts during the Steeler games and promoted during the Baltimore Steeler games to bring people from the DC Baltimore area up to Fayette County. So, I mean, this is a really amazing county. It's only growing and getting better. And I'm happy to be a part of it. And with our education part here with the Fayette Business Education Partnership has grown exponentially in the last 5 years that I've been here. So
it's not that far from Allegheny County.
It is not.
So I've done a lot of work in that county. So that's what I've done over the years. Which leads me to a new endeavor that I'm helping you with that I really want to talk about in a couple of minutes. But let me just touch on Spark Fayette. What was Spark Fayette?
So Spark Fayette is an entrepreneurship program. We have one of our local banks, Somerset Trust, is our primary sponsor of that program. So what we do is it's kind of like a Shark Tank, but more educational. So we bring students from the business department together and we go over what it's like to build a business plan, how to do a pitch, how to create a product. And we use mentors who are entrepreneurs in Fayette County to kind of work with them on how to create this pitch. We do a workshop day, which is that type of stuff where we teach them how to do all this. And then we do a competition day where they have to come back and they pitch to three judges. Then the judges figure out who's first, second, third. And then they get a monetary prize whenever for the winners. So
what an incredible learning experience.
It is. It is. And the last time we did it, the program was actually in 2019. We had everything ready. We were ready to go in our program was going to be in March of 2020. And we all know what happened in March of 2020.
The world shut down.
So the world shut down. And so we haven't been able to bring the program back just because of a lot, obviously in the last 3 years, the world changed. Our lives here have changed at the chamber. And so our goal is to do that program in the fall.
Oh, nice, nice. But we have another program coming up very soon in next month. You want to talk about that?
So last year we decided that we were going to do a youth leadership program. The youth leadership program that we did last year was actually our first program back since COVID. And what we did was we brought together 15 students from all four of the six school districts in our county. And we did a leadership type program. They learned leadership in the morning, and then we went and did tours of various different places throughout the week. So we went to the courthouse. They got to go through the county courthouse. They met with a district attorney. They met with a judge. They met with our county commissioners. We went to a business called COE Distributing, which does office furniture throughout the entire United States. The kids were fascinated with a forklift. It was amazing.
Sure, right. Big toy.
We also did workforce, of course. I mean, that's what we specialize in. We went to the Fayette Career Link and they learned about the different services that they provide. And we we had a finance day. We talked about financial planning and that kind of stuff. They got to learn about stocks. We went to a local bank that's a chamber member. So that was last year. It was a great program. We're trying it again this year, and we're expanding the program to a second week. Right. And we're going to focus on healthcare, because healthcare is a very, very important, one of the number one industries in Fayette County.
Yeah. So this is so exciting. So what are the age groups of the students that will be participating in this
program? So our goal is to recruit incoming. So 2023, when they start school in the fall, will be sophomores, juniors, and seniors.
Okay.
And we have 6 school districts in Fayette County, including our 2 career and technical education centers that we're recruiting from. So we expect to get a lot of our health occupation students from our career and technical centers for the healthcare program. And I'm hoping that we can get some really great students for both programs.
And how many students are you expecting?
Our goal is 15.
Two different weeks, right?
15 for each week, yes.
Yeah. And hopefully you still have some spots open. So if someone sees it, they can contact you. We'll have
all absolutely. Your information. Yep. We do have some spaces limited.
Spaces limited, right. Going fast. A few seats left. So what is the day of the program, Kathi, in case someone is interested or someone's watches and they think, oh, my child would be perfect for this?
So we're weird. we started with a middle of the week kind of program. So the first day for our general leadership starts Wednesday, June 7th, and that's an evening. So we like to bring the students together and do team building, because a lot of the students don't know each other. They all go to different schools. And so we'll bring them together here at the chamber office, and we do team building activities. So last year we did Jenga, the real big Jenga blocks.
Yeah.
We sat them down in the middle of our foyer, and they had to pick Jenga blocks, and we put questions on them, so they had to answer like, what would you do if you're invisible? And then we also did an activity with them where they had to build something out of Legos, but they had to have a person that built, one that went and looked at the thing, and one that couldn't talk. So like it was a really great activity. So we will do that with them on the Wednesday evening. Of course, we'll provide dinner, food, and then we'll go over the week and then we, you know, leave for the night, and right. Then we come back the next morning. So that would be June 8th. And then we go at June 8th and 9th, and then Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday of the following week. So the 12th, 13th, and 14th. The 14th will be a wrap-up day. That's where they're going to do a project. And we're still trying to figure out what that project is going to be. So the healthcare then starts Thursday evening, the 15th, and we'll do the same thing, do team building activities, blah, blah, blah. Hopefully make them more towards healthcare. And then we start right into the program on the 16th. That's the Friday. And then back on Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday would be the wrap up and the Thursday. Wednesday and Thursday. Thursday is the group project report out for the healthcare. So it'll be 2 weeks in June. And then I'm going to go take a nap after that because I'm going to be exhausted.
Right. So the whole thing focuses on leadership.
Yes.
All those days. And I know I'm really honored to be helping you out, and I'll be presenting some leadership. And we're going to talk about a lot of different things in leadership. Mm-hmm. So I think a lot of these students, when they come in, they have a different ideas of what being a leader really entails.
Yes. So last year's project was probably what we might end up doing for the general leadership again. I really enjoyed it. We did the project last year was, who is your ideal leader and why? Mm-hmm. And they had to come up with what a leader is, and then who is your ideal leader and why? And there were so many different, I don't even think they overlapped with who their ideal leader was. The 15 different kids, they all had 15 different aspects of what a leader was. Even one of them chose Shrek. as a leader.
Right, right.
I mean, that's how creative these kids were. Phenomenal kids last year. I'm so excited to do this program again this year. And I really like what that project came out to be. They could present that project in any way they wanted. They could do a PowerPoint. They could just read an essay. They could do, some of them wanted to do interpretive dance. I mean, if they came up, they were going to do that. It didn't.
Okay.
Yeah. So they're very creative, and we wanted to bring that creativity out in them, because I don't think a lot of times in high school, they get to be that creative.
Yeah, it's very, very structured, very structured. Mm-hmm.
And I'm super excited to be able to bring you into the fold and do the leadership part of the program. We had Sarah Sladek last year from XYZ University. She is phenomenal, but I wanted to make sure that we brought someone in local. And whenever we were trying to decide what we were going to do with the program, you were immediately top of my list.
Oh, thank you.
So I said to my boss, Muriel, I'm like, I have a friend that could probably do the leadership part. Let's reach out and see what happens. And you took it and ran. And I'm excited to see what happens during the 2 weeks. And I look forward to doing more.
Kathi, is there any restrictions on the students that can apply to this program?
Not really. We like to bring in the kids that their teachers or administration recognize as students that could be a leader, but those students don't think they can be a leader.
Right.
Those are the kids that we like to target. Obviously, we'll take anyone that wants to participate, but I really try to get the teachers to look at those kids who maybe are a little introverted, and we need to pull them out and make them extroverts. That was one of the skills that they did last year. We did with them was the extrovert introvert test, and a lot of them realized they could be extroverts and introverts at the same time.
I'm the same.
Yeah, me too, because I don't like to be around people.
And I'll actually tell that story, how I went from where I was in high school to where I am now. So it's a big change. So
yeah.
I'm really excited.
Yeah. So that's what we're trying to look for in the kids to participate. I don't even really feel like we say we want, like, they need to have this GPA, blah, blah, blah. Right. But really, I just want kids that are interested in the program, that want to take a week out, get to know other students, and just have fun with this program. There were students last year that we laugh about it. We say they were voluntold to come and be part of the program. One of them was my boss's daughter. She was voluntold to be a part of the program, but she came away with new friends that she had never met before. And they wanted to come back a second week. Why can't we have this another week? We had another chamber member whose daughter participated, and she was voluntold to be a part of it. And again, she's like, I'm coming back and I'm going to do the healthcare portion this year because it's different from what I did. I mean, it's stuff like that. Like, we encourage them to go out and bring their friends, because that, you know, I can't get over how I love this group of kids, and I hope that we have another group just like them.
Yeah. And it's just, I don't know, it gives me so much hope knowing that there's students out there that want to take a week in their summer vacation.
Yes. Yes. We tried to make sure it was early in the summer vacation. Right. They come in. And that was part of another reason why we kind of pushed it into the second week towards the end of June, because who knows how the weather's going to be in the first week of June. We didn't know if there were going to be any snow days, because still down here in Fayette, they still did like days off and not too many virtual days, but we didn't have any school snow days. So the first week of June is always graduations. And then we started halfway through. They have a couple days they could sleep in and then start with us with the program. So, yeah.
It's going to be a great program. Again, there are some spots left in both weeks.
Yep, both weeks.
And your contact information will be here. They can reach out to you directly, right?
Yeah, and they can get the information for the program on the Fayette Business Education Partnership website, which is fayettebep.org. Application and program information are both on there.
Okay, but they have to be Fayette County.
Yes.
Yes.
Because of the funding, we received grant funding from the Westmoreland Fayette Workforce Investment Board, and we try to focus on our Fayette County students. And that could be parochial schools as well. So we've reached out to Geibel Catholic High School, and we've reached out. We had students last year from Calvary Chapel in Brownsville who participated, and have reached out to them as well. So any student in Fayette County, whether they're a public or even charter cyber homeschool students, if they want to are interested in participating, it's a little hard to get to them. We don't really have contacts. So if you have any friends that are in Fayette County that have kids that are going into be sophomore, juniors, or seniors that may be interested in healthcare, please have them sign up for the healthcare portion. Or if you feel that they need to be pushed a little bit into believing they can be that leader, have them sign up for our general leadership. I'm really excited. We are making some changes to the program based on what the students' feedback was from last year. So I can't wait to do this program. It's slowly becoming one of my favorites. So we'll see what happens.
That's all we can do is see it happens. This is so exciting, Kathi, but what else is coming up for the chamber? Like after you get through this and sleep.
And sleep. So summer months, we kind of talk about it. It's a little slow, not slow, because we're never slow. We don't do anything slow in our world. But the fall is really when our activities start back up again. So we do have, chamber-wise, we do have business after hours where we do our networking with our businesses. We have one of those a month. We are planning a membership meeting for all of our members or potential members coming up in, I believe, in July. Because I think all of June is being taken up by leadership. So July and August. And then we also, with the Fayette Business Education Partnership, we do have meetings that are once every other month, except for June and July, we kind of skip. So our next meeting is in August. We average about 50 employers, school districts, workforce agencies that come to that meeting. Last meeting in May, earlier this month, we had a phenomenal conversation about Generation X and Z and Ys and how they work together. And we had two Gen Zs in the room, and they're like the anomaly for Gen Zs. So we try to talk about workforce issues with those meetings. And again, I talked about Spark Fayette this fall. Our mechanical design competition is with the Fayette Business Education Partnership side. On the chamber side, some big activities we have is our mini golf tournament that we do. A lot of other places do golf tournaments, big golf tournaments. Nope, not us. We like mini golf. So we have a mini golf tournament. And we have, in October is our huge month. We are responsible for the Uniontown Downtown Halloween Parade. And that averages about 3 hours.
Yeah, right. I think the Park Parade. I know exactly what you're talking about. It's a whole lot of doing this and waving in those cars and everything.
Yes, it's over. We have averaged about 80 to 90 participants in that parade. We do our ghost tours because some places around downtown Uniontown are haunted. They're fun.
I'll be part of that. You need to let me know about that.
I will. And then, of course, our annual dinner is in November, which is always fun and exciting to have. And then we kind of, take a little bit of break mid-December and then gear right back up for the new year.
Well, people are watching this and they have students in Fayette County, or you know of students in Fayette County, reach out to Kathi, because this is going to be a phenomenal leadership program.
Yep.
If you know businesses in Fayette County or you're a business in Fayette County, again, reach out to the Chamber of Commerce, because it's so important to network with other business owners and you have the same issues and know what's going on in your community.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So if you are a current chamber member or not, we are doing sponsorships for this for the leadership program as well. So if you're interested in sponsoring, we have some expenses that we have to pay for this program, especially food is a big one, because we got to feed our kiddos when they come for lunch. And it's really difficult to try to find a place that caters to all of the kids and their special needs of food challenges. And then there is a little bit of transportation costs. So if you're watching this and you're a Fayette Chamber member, please sponsor. If you're not a chamber member, you need to become one. Right. You can give me a call for that because I do some membership as well.
Just call Kathi. Kathi does it all.
My boss has the team. We all work together. We have a great staff here.
Right. And it's a great place right on Main Street. I was there just recently.
Yes.
I just really appreciate everything you do for the community. It's just awesome, Kathi.
Thanks. I appreciate you and your help with this program.
Oh, it's going to be great. Thank you so much for taking your time out of your day. You have your Fayette County shirt on. Make sure you share that. There we go. Fayette Chamber.
Fayette Chamber shirt.
Yes. And I look forward to this program. Again, it's a great opportunity. As I meant to ask you, there's no cost for this to the students either, right?
Correct. That's, again, goes with the sponsorships. If because we were going to charge at least to help offset, but we decided to go the sponsorship route. So yeah, there's no cost for the participate.
No reason why they can't participate.
No reason at all why they can't participate.
Well, Kathi, thank you so much for being here today, and good luck with the program. I know it's going to be fabulous. I can't wait to get started with it.
Me too.
Everybody, hello, and I'll see you guys in a couple of weeks, I guess, right?
It sounds good. Yep.
Thank you for watching today's episode of Empowering You. I'd like to thank my guest, Kathi Hull. The Fayette Chamber is doing amazing things with the local high schools in Fayette County and this new leadership program that's beginning in a few weeks. It's an amazing opportunity for these students to be empowered and inspired and help plan their future. I'm so thankful I was able to participate in this upcoming program and also bring it to you so you could see and hear what amazing things that are going on with these students. If you have any students that would be interested in this, please reach out to Kathi. It's awesome that these students will be empowered, inspired, and are enthusiastic for their career choices. Thank you for watching. See you next time. Thank you.